The creatures you see living in these rocky places feed by catching passing plankton in the water. Seaweeds are slowly beginning to grow in the cold water. It is early spring. As the sunlight increases and warms the water, these small plants emit ribbon-like protrusions from their round heads. Seaweeds extend up to 98 or 131 feet to the surface in order to trap the sunlight. Southern California. Kelp living among other seaweeds. Kelps can grow as much as 18 inches a day in the middle of summer, and they possess a high photosynthesis capacity. They are attached to the rocks below by their tangled holdfast system. The holdfast is the root-like part of the kelp. These giant plants constitute marine forest by growing up to 213 feet tall. The animal known as the blacksmith fish lives in this marine forest. It feeds on plankton. If it is safe, the fish travel to the open sea, which is rich in plankton. If they encounter a danger, they immediately return to the marine forest. It is not only fish that live in these forests. Sea otters also rest and sleep in safety here. They install themselves in seaweed to avoid being dragged along in the water. The otter later descends to the seafloor to feed. Sea otters have dense fur on the undersides of their bodies. This serves to repel water and soon dries out after becoming wet. Sea otters have very flexible bodies. The muscular tail is thick and flat at the base, tapering to a point. This feature assists the sea otter in swimming. A great many species of sea otter have webbed feet. All this makes the otter a most expert swimmer. God has created all the features of the otter, a water dweller, in such a way as to allow it to move through the water with ease. God reveals in one verse of the Quran that He has created living things with different features. God created every animal from water. Some of them go on their bellies, some of them on two legs, and some on four. God creates whatever He wills. God has power over all things. Contrary to what is popularly believed, seahorses are very small creatures. Their size varies from about 1.6 to 11.8 inches. They usually live along the shore, among seaweed and plants. A bony armor protects them from any kind of hazard. This armor is so strong that it is impossible to crush a dried, dead seahorse using only your hands. The head of the seahorse is set at a right angle to its body. Seahorses swim with their bodies straight up, and they can bend their heads up and down. But they cannot turn their heads from side to side. This might cause sight problems in other creatures, but seahorses have none thanks to their special bodily features. The seahorse's eyes can move independently, rotating about to watch each side so they can see their surroundings easily. Their eyes, which can see in several directions at the same time, represent a grave danger for their prey. Male seahorses possess a pouch resembling that of the female kangaroo. During mating time, the female seahorse deposits a large number of eggs into this pouch. The eggs stay in the pouch for 1.5 months. The male seahorse feeds the eggs with a liquid inside the pouch. Capillary vessels in the interior tissue of the incubating sac provide a supply of oxygen. Once the eggs have developed, minute seahorses emerge from the pouch. The way that seahorses move in the water is particularly amazing. Their swimming is affected by a very special system. It rises and sinks in the water by changing the volume of the gas in its swim bladder. If this bladder is damaged and loses a little bit of gas, the seahorse sinks to the bottom. Such a mishap causes the seahorse to die. Here there is a very important point that should not be missed. The amount of gas in the bladder has been adjusted in a very sensitive way. For this reason, the slightest change may cause the death of the creature. The seahorse, which is only one of the millions of species living beneath the sea, has unique characteristics in many aspects. The amazing attributes of the seahorse is just one example of God's boundless power and eternal knowledge. God reveals this fact thus in the Quran. Among his signs is the creation of the heavens and the earth, and all the creatures he has spread about in them. And he has the power to gather them together whenever he wills. In this film we have witnessed the magnificent creation of God that can be observed throughout the entire universe. We have seen examples from the living world equipped with incomparable features. Yet here is an important point that we should not forget. No matter how many examples we give, these will never be enough to illustrate the eternal power and matchless knowledge of God. God is the only one who has the most beautiful names and complete power. Everything, both animate and inanimate, whether you see it or not, can only function and operate with God's permission. God creates all human beings and animate and inanimate objects and keeps them under his control. As it is related in the Quran, there is no creature he does not hold by the forelock. What befalls a person who is aware of these facts is to lead a life as God commands and to do good to please him. Everyone must eliminate the causes that make him heedless of God's remembrance and that hamper him from thinking through his own efforts. He is God, the creator, the maker, the giver of form. To him belong the most beautiful names. Everything in the heavens and earth glorifies him. He is the Almighty, the All-Wise.